sliding sprites across the screen works great for simple projects in Scratch. But if you really want to bring your stories and games to life, you need to unleash the power of costumes. If you hover your cursor over objects in Scratch's sprite library, you'll see that many of them are designed with pre-built animations. You can access these poses, Scratch calls them costumes, by clicking in the Costumes tab at the top left of your screen. You can switch between these costumes using the purple looks blocks in your code library. This one flips you over to the next costume on the list. And this one contains a pull-down menu that lets you pick a specific costume to wear. These blocks seem pretty straightforward, but when it comes time to use them in your games and stories, new Scratchers often run into trouble with timing. In this chunk of code, adding next costume blocks will make our character move his feet and then slide across the screen frozen like a statue, before switching poses again after all the movement is done. How do we get our character to move and change his costumes at the same time? The problem here is that Scratch always processes stacks of code in a linear fashion. First do this, then move down to the next row and do this. What new Scratchers often don't realize, though, is that Scratch is capable of running more than one stack of code at the same time. If I split the action up into two different threads, I can use the first stack of code to handle the costume changes, and use the second one to control the motion. And now Scratch is doing both actions all at once.
Go Scratch, go! Go Scratch, go!
I feel the liftoff. The clock has started. Roger.